Hello, and welcome to this week's Maps GDL. I'm Brett Morgan, one of the developer relations engineers working with the Maps team here in Sydney. This week, I'd like to take you on a tour of using Google Maps with Dart. What is Dart, I hear you say? Dart is a new programming language from Google designed to bring structured programming to web applications. This includes things like classes, libraries, package management, and tooling. Here you can see the most visible tool of the Dart project, the Dart Editor, available at dartlang.org. This tool is based on the Eclipse framework and is thus available cross-platform. To get started, let's create a new application. I'm going to call this one Maps App. First thing I always do when starting a new project is make sure the darn thing actually runs. So here we go, launching it up and making sure it reacts. That looks good to me. We have a working tool chain. So the next step, and one of the things I mentioned that was great about Dart, is that it has packages. In this case, I went to pub.dartlang.org and found that there was a package that wraps the JavaScript Google Maps API up in a nice and Dart-friendly way. So once I actually save this pubspec.yaml file, you'll actually see the packages included in this application will grow to include Google Maps and all the things that Google Maps depends on. So now we can actually go ahead and start writing a Maps application. So the first thing to do is put a div on the screen, this one here, that will include the map. Second thing is to make sure that we include the Google JavaScript API for Maps. Next, and this is something I keep forgetting to do, is to make sure the map canvas actually has a height. And what I'm doing here on both the body and the map canvas is making sure that we take 100% of the screen. Next, let's write some Dart code. So what we have here is, as I was mentioning before, it has tools and it has packages. So what we have here is the first one, Dart.html, gives us the ability to reach into the DOM and use CSS selectors to pull nodes out of the DOM, or elements in this case. The next thing is the Google Maps.dart file. It includes object wrappers for things like map options. So traditionally in JavaScript, this map options is a bare JavaScript object with key value pairs. In the Dart version, we actually have typed setters and getters for each of these attributes of map options. So we know that zoom takes a number, map type ID takes a map type ID object, so on and so forth. And we wrap that all up, throw it into a Google map, and off we run. And we have a working map. Now the next step is that I like my maps to, you know, be on the screen and be nicely visible, but I'm not quite sure what numbers to put in here to pull out the specific detail I want. So what I'm gonna do now is that I've added a pair of change listeners to the map, one for the zoom level and one for the center. So now what I'm going to do is when I rerun the project is that I can turn around and center the map where I want it, zoom in, get the location in Sydney that looks pretty. How about there? Maybe a little bit further in. That looks good to me. Okay, now I have some magic numbers. Now that I have these magic numbers printed so beautifully in the console here by Dart, I can put them back in the source code. And rerun the application. That looks a whole lot better. Now I can actually see a chunk of Sydney that I'm interested in walking around. Okay. If you're watching our Google I/O announcements, either live at the venue or online afterwards, you'll know that we released a new set of map tiles. How do we get to these from Dart? Well, this is the JavaScript package that I was talking about up here. This allows us to reach into the JavaScript context and set true to this part of the tree here. And this will turn around and allow for a new set of tiles to be pulled in by the Google Maps API. As you can see, a much better set of colors and I think a much more readable map. The next step is, of course, with any map, is to put a whole bunch of red dots on it. So I have a data JSON file I prepared earlier. This data data file is care of the Places API, which you can look up on Google Maps. And what we have here is a set of lat longs and a bunch of restaurant names. So what I want to do now is to put this on the map. So first things first, let's head into the Dart, and you can probably guess what comes next. We're including a package that allows us to turn JSON objects into native Dart objects. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to write a function that walks that Dart structure and pulls out what we're interested in, i.e. the lat long and the name. So what's happening here? We're making a request back to the server to get the data JSON file, this one here, and then once that is successfully retrieved, we run this inline function. It's a nice inline anonymous function for those of you keeping score at home, to actually parse the data, walk through, and then create a set of markers to put on the map. Now, the most important step when you're creating something like this is to actually call the code. So there we go. Hopefully, I've lined everything up correctly and we'll now have a map. Look at that, map with red markers. So I can zoom in here a bit, hover over things, and we'll see titles of pizza places around Sydney. What have I shown you here? I've shown you how to easily use Google Maps from Dart. Just a handful of lines of code has us visualizing JSON data on a map. Please reach out to me on Google Plus if you have any questions. Thank you.